It's the music of an era gone by, one that's close to the heart of this Cuban-born singer.
For me, Punto Guajiro, besides being a type of music, it makes me feel authentically Cuban, and it's part of my family and the way I was raised.
And for those who pack into Central Vasco restaurant to hear Albita perform every Saturday night, the music brings them home.
The music, Cuban, makes you, reminds you that you're Cuban. You feel it in your bones.
I got a feeling of pride of where my parents come from and happy to be Cuban.
Albita came to the U.S. through Mexico just 2 years ago. And though she liked music, it was not her first career choice.
I started studying aircraft engineering, and at the same time, I got my first guitar. Then I had to decide between the two, and eventually, I chose the guitar.
She made the right decision. After hearing the singer perform in the restaurant, Emilio Estefan decided he spotted a star and signed her to his Crescent Moon record label. Her new album, No Si Parece Nada, translated It Doesn't Look Like Anything, has just been released in record stores today.
I saw, you know, a real talent, a real human being, and somebody who came from Cuba looking for a lot of hope. So to me, she represents a lot of things, and definitely represents the American dream.
Lately, she's had music critics all over the world positively gushing. Dubbed the Cuban Katie Lang, Albita's style is both macho and sensuous. All the attention has been a bit much for this quiet singer. To calm herself, she picks up a microphone and sings. It's the only place, she says, she really feels most at home.